As if the McCrispy couldn't get any better, Bacon and Ranch just entered the chat. The Bacon Ranch McCrispy, available at participating McDonald's for a limited time. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
This episode is sponsored by State Farm. Choices are great. Like with your podcasts, you get to choose what you want to listen to. And State Farm believes insurance should work the same way. That's why the State Farm Personal Price Plan helps you get the coverage you want at an affordable price and a policy that helps cover what you value most. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Call or go to statefarm.com today to create your State Farm Personal Price Plan. Prices vary by state. Options selected by customer. Availability and eligibility may vary.
The Purple Mafia with your host, Paladino Joey.
Well, we'll see. The doctors would disagree, but what do they know?
So let's just say that you'll pay me because it's in your interest to pay me.
Is it worth it? I mean, you've won. Do you want to wipe everybody out?
I don't feel I have to wipe everybody out, Tom. Just my enemies. That's all. My father taught me many things. He taught me, keep your friends close. Put your enemies closer.
These are wonderful things that we've achieved, and there's no limit to where we can go from here.
And welcome to the family here on Purple Mafia. I am your host, Paladino Joey, or Joey Awajin. Purple Mafia is available on thesportstuff.com and on iTunes. I thank each and every one of you always for downloading and listening to this show. I am back here once again today. Well, we are now three games into the preseason, just one more to go, and then we get into the regular season, the long-awaited regular season, or for some of us, short-awaited, because the summer feels oh so short. Man, I'm going to miss it. Only 1 week left of August. Despite the fact it's been one of the most humid months of August of all time. Makes you want to have a little can of that Halcyon Wheat Ale from Tallgrass. That's their summer cooler, we'll call it, because you know how certain beers are winter warmers. But yeah, you'll hear about Tallgrass later in the jingles. Well, three games into the preseason, this was the most regular season looking type of game, and the Vikings looked awfully damn good, didn't they? Yeah, I mean, very, very, very nice indeed, pounding the Kansas City Chiefs into submission, at least for the most part. for the most part. Yeah, a nice, strong 30-12 victory over the Kansas City Chiefs. The Chiefs scoring a touchdown to make it 12 because there was a safety in this game. That's why the number is so weird. Unfortunately, the safety against Matt Cassel in the Minnesota Vikings. Fourth game of the preseason will be this Thursday, the 28th of August. Not too long from now, a Thursday night game. So those of you working second shift like me, get your NFL mobile ready, especially if you're a Verizon Wireless customer. Wes, that's when you're more lucky to be able to have it. Obviously, some of you have the preseason app out there. Unfortunately, you've heard nothing but negative stuff. It's all one-star ratings on there, so that's the crappy part. It wasn't the $20 that pissed people off. It's the fact that it didn't work, so... But hopefully the NFL mobile app will work at least. I hope so. We're going to be doing our best with that one. Otherwise, I will have to rewatch it, unfortunately, before I record the show. And then we'll get into our, the next show will be the season preview. Because the fourth game, you know, we talk about the cuts and such. Haven't been any major cuts as of yet, so the next show we'll be talking a hell of a lot more about cut downs and such. We'll see if there's any surprises up and coming. Nothing yet. Nothing big going on as of yet. Yes, sir, Tennessee Titans in Tennessee. Got it like that. Coming up on Thursday. Thursday night football has a negative history. Sunday night football has a very positive history. Though neither have a positive history for the Vikings, but a positive history in terms of the matchup itself throughout the NFL. All right, I'm kind of going off into not la-la land here. A fun game, for the most part. The Vikings, they look pretty good on the defensive side and the offensive side. Kind of showing their true colors a bit. Though at the same time, it's more or less you look for tendencies of this and that, not so much of like, wow, we're going to kick everybody's ass, we're going to win the Super Bowl, but, you know, because obviously that's a bit far-fetched right now. Some teams play well in the preseason, some teams play poorly in the preseason. Doesn't always reflect on where the regular season is headed. Last year, like I've said a million times, you could tell where the team was headed because the offensive line was poop. Christian Ponder couldn't, Christian Ponder couldn't do anything. Couldn't hit the broadside of a barn, couldn't tough his way through a play, couldn't make a play if his life depended on it. It was a flat-out joke. No Christian Ponder the past 2 weeks. Isn't that nice? Isn't that nice not having to watch him play? Yeah, but Matt Cassel kind of coming back down to earth a little bit against the Kansas City Chiefs, throwing a pick in this game. Not the sharpest thing you've ever seen, but really early on, Shades of 98 on a deep pass to Cordarrelle Patterson. Oh, wasn't that fun? And Cordarrelle Patterson just beat the defender. He just beat him. I mean, he blew by him. And an accurate pass by Matt Cassel. Cordarrelle Patterson didn't really have to. I think he maybe had to slow down a teensy tiny bit, but that's not a big deal. He was still able to catch it in stride, and the defender had no chance to catch him. 7-0 Minnesota. That was a lot of fun to watch. Matt Cassel, unfortunately, fumbled and was called for a safety about 5 minutes later. It's just one of those situations. Kansas City does have, when they rush the quarterback, they look pretty tough. I mean, it's been a tradition there pretty much forever, at least, for the most part. Kansas City Chiefs, Minnesota in Arrowhead is usually a disaster. So kind of cool to see the Vikings win, even if it was a preseason game in Arrowhead. We've seen many solid seasons get derailed by going to Arrowhead. The 99 Vikings lost a chance for home field advantage by going to Arrowhead that year. It was a quite unfortunate loss. The Vikings were winning most of that game and lost it, but obviously that was long ago. But just saying, lots and lots of games over the years where the Vikings have really struggled in Arrowhead. Remember, they got absolutely crushed by the... by the Kansas City Chiefs a few years back in 2011 when Donovan McNabb was the quarterback. Oh boy, we don't really want to remember that too much. This game, I mean, what more can you get out of it other than, Cassel? I think this is about what Cassel is overall. He's going to have some good games and he's going to have some eh games. He was kind of in the middle of eh and good, I guess, in this one. I think this really is what you're going to get out of Matt Cassel. Overall, his completion percentage will be higher. Sure, we'll give him that. Obviously, not the most mobile guy in the history of the world. He's going to get sacked. He got sacked 3 times in the game. The pass rush did get to him a bit. And like any quarterback, when there is a pass rush, they're going to struggle a little bit. And Matt Cassel did struggle a little bit in this one. 9 of 17 overall in the game. One interception, luckily not two. Alex Smith sucks. No, yeah, kind of. He didn't look good in this game. 2 interceptions overall. Vikings pass rush did get to him fairly well. Not very good decisions. Not very good passes. Just not accurate passes. The same kind of guy that, you know, Matt Cassel and Alex Smith are kind of similar in a way. They're good enough to be a starter in the league, but obviously not good enough to be called the quarterback of the future. Luckily for the Vikings, we didn't draft Matt Cassel #1 overall. Well, luckily for the Chiefs, they didn't draft Alex Smith #1 overall, but San Francisco did. They just got super lucky by getting Colin Kaepernick, who also is inconsistent, but certainly an overall more skilled guy than Alex Smith. Alex Smith just, to me, I would not want to be sitting here saying, well, that's our quarterback for the next five or so years. I really wouldn't want that. I mean, we're very lucky, very fortunate to have Teddy Bridgewater on the sidelines, and obviously he did come in this one. Third game of the preseason. Yeah, numbers, obviously there's a reason why he's only got 40 yards in the game, because the special teams and Adam Thielen had a very nice return on the second touchdown. Or actually the first one. The second touchdown was it was basically like a two passes and a touchdown for Teddy Bridgewater. And then The second one was an interception by Sean Prater, who returned it almost to the house as well. One pass and a second touchdown in the game for Teddy Bridgewater. So, didn't really get to... It was like, that's great, that's awesome. I mean, if this was a regular season game, hell yeah. You know, awesome, hell yeah. We're kicking their ass. This is spectacular. Who cares if Teddy Bridgewater isn't racking up the numbers or this or that? But it would have been nice to see more of what Teddy Bridgewater can do out there. More chance to see him drive against the Kansas City Chiefs, but the field position was so doggone good, he didn't really have to drive the team very far. It's basically like a touchdown was a first down for the most part, if you know what I mean. But his release, and overall, like I'm going to get to in the Facebook page, it's going to be a two-segment show like last one. Regular season, it will be a three-segment show. The game review, the game preview, and the fan interaction, of course, in the preseason. There's no reason to preview a game. It's more or less talk about news or and so here and there in the first segment and kind of in the second segment as well with the fan interaction on Facebook, Twitter. And we do have a call-in from Brent Jacobson, which is very, very good stuff. So just letting you know about that. The quarterback position, I think we're in good hands overall. Matt Cassel, good enough to be a starter, not good enough to be a franchise quarterback, and everybody knows that, of course. I mean, it's just, we're just kind of seeing why he's not a franchise quarterback. I mean, he's not going to go out there and dominate on a weekly basis. Teddy Bridgewater, who knows? He's got some special skills. It's going to be fun to see him continue to develop more and more. Some of Matt Cassel's throws were pretty wobbly. They're pretty wobbly. Teddy Bridgewater, though, I'm telling you, that quick release and that just that, the way he sails the ball is a thing of beauty. The way he hits his receivers in stride, where only, like I said, only the receiver can catch it. The defender can't catch it. And he throws it, like we said, in stride. And sure, Castles was thrown in stride to Mr. Cordarrelle Patterson. But the way Bridgewater just sails it in there, back corner of the end zone, I just love that kind of stuff. I love it. And he's got the makings to be a very, very good quarterback in this league. A bit surprised, though. Some people think they just don't like him. They don't really think he's going to be much in this league. I'm seeing special skills out of this one, guys. I didn't see special skills out of Christian Ponder. You just never saw it. You never saw even a hint of it. He didn't even give you a chance. Christian Ponder didn't even give you a chance to come on the air or go on Facebook or Twitter or to your cubicle at work or whatever, if you're lucky enough to work in a cubicle versus just, like, labor nonsense. to come out and say Christian Ponder has special skills. Teddy Bridgewater has special skills, folks. Yep, and it's great. Matt Cassel is a quarterback. Teddy Bridgewater, I think, is going to be a level higher than that. I do, and you can see it. Is he going to be a superstar in this league? Well, obviously way too early to say, but he has the makings of an above-average quarterback in this league. Matt Cassel has the makings of a slightly above-average quarterback in this league. It's like you say, above average early on, because yeah, I mean, I think Teddy Bridgewater's gonna be above average. After that, we'll see. How far above average is all a matter of. It's gonna be a matter of time, a matter of development, and I do have an unbelievable amount of confidence, and I'm so happy I can come on the air and say this today. That I have confidence in this coaching staff that Teddy Bridgewater will be developed correctly. Were we able to say that for the X amount of years with the previous quarterbacks, Tavares Jackson, Christian Ponder? Were we able to say that with the previous offensive coordinators and head coaches and quarterbacks coaches? Possibly some of them under Childress. I mean, Daryl Bevel has become a pretty good coordinator, but certainly not in the Leslie Frazier era. Certainly not. Certainly bleeping not. Under Mr. I don't even want to remember his name. Bill Musgrave. I almost forgot, which is kind of funny. Very forgettable. Oh my God, how can you not have faith in this coaching staff? It's very exciting on the offensive side of the ball. Defensive side, heck, your head coach specializes in it, and it showed. I mean, it's just wave after wave after wave after wave. It really is. It's a thing of beauty to watch this defense continue to develop under Mike Zimmer and, of course, George Edwards. I mean, it is an awesome thing. So they're certainly not perfect, and nobody's going to be perfect. And, of course, the personnel is always going to be an issue, just like Tavares Jackson probably was such an inferior quarterback that regardless of how good Daryl Bevel is or isn't, he wasn't going to develop under Daryl Bevel. I mean, a coach can't wave a magic wand and suddenly the guy's a good quarterback. But, hey, good coaches are more likely to develop the right type of quarterback in the right situation. This is looking like it's heading in that direction. Boy, the sacks did rack up for the Vikings in this one. Gotta like that. Brian Robinson with a half sack. Jasper Brinkley Jasper Brinkley very active in this one. A half sack, two tackles overall. Nice game. Nice game for him. Jasper Brinkley's looking like an okay, you know, obviously he's not going to play every down because, well, obviously when there's a nickel, Jasper Brinkley's not going to be in there. And that's fine. That's the good part, because you don't necessarily want Jasper Brinkley out there all the time. But he sure looks better with this coaching scheme, doesn't he, versus the previous one. Doesn't he look better? Man, I would say so. Captain Munnerlin, again. The best cornerback on the team, without a doubt. The new Antoine Winfield? Definitely. I mean, the new Antoine Winfield, and he did get an interception, which is the one thing Antoine Winfield wasn't so hot at. Very cool. Chad Greenway with another interception. Pass deflected, both by Munnerlin and Greenway as well in this one. Sean Prater with an interception, like I mentioned. Almost took it to the house. Not quite. Not quite. Anthony Barr did not get a three-peat in sacks, but again, very active. Looks like he's going to have an awesome career in this league. Adi Cole all over the place, special teams and, you know, out there in snaps as well. How could you not like Adi Cole? I mean, if he got cut, I'd be flat-out shocked. Seven tackles overall for him. I mean, Adi Cole, like I've said on the last show, I'm pretty happy with this. I'm pretty happy with the linebackers, and it's been a while since I've been able to say that. I mean, it's like going back in the day. You could be like, wow, we have some nice linebackers. I mean, we're talking like late 90s here. Like Ed McDaniel and Dwayne Rudd, back when Dwayne Rudd was actually good, like his first 2 years in the league or so. After that, it's like Dwayne Rudd sucks, man, and it got really frustrating watching him play. It's just like, yeah, good stuff, wasn't it? But, yeah, in the grand scheme of things, a solid game for the defense. I mean, just one wave after another. Xavier Rhodes looked better than last week. Like I was saying last week, I was like really impressed with Xavier Rhodes. And yes, to be fair, obviously he did get burned a couple times. And it's going to happen. Obviously, you know, cornerbacks are going to get scored on occasion. Xavier Rhodes is going to get scored on sometimes. But overall, I'm very happy with Xavier Rhodes. I think he has a nice career ahead of him. A lot of people expressing a ton of fear last week about Xavier Rhodes. Just scared to death like this. Is this guy going to be a good cornerback in this league, or is he just not? I think he is. He had another pass deflection in this game as well. Didn't really get burned in this one. A solid overall night. Not perfect. Got beat a couple times here and there. I mean, guys are going to catch the ball here. It's not like they're going to get 0 yards passing. It's going to happen. I mean, this is a quarterback's league, even though Kansas City Chiefs quarterbacks were not real good. The pass that Prater intercepted, boy, either it was a horrible miscue or a horribly underthrown ball, because the receiver was way ahead of where the ball was thrown, way ahead of it. Not sure if it was a miscue or if it was just a badly thrown pass, but Prater, doing what he needed to do, sniffed it out, made the catch, and well, yeah, helped the Vikings score a touchdown one play later. You got it like that. Prater, I do think, makes the team, by the way. He's been pretty good the whole way here. Viking secondary, not perfect, but a lot better this week than last. I mean, it was a little scary at times last week. That's why a lot of people are, again, screaming bloody murder about Xavier Rhodes. At least some people out there. Kind of a mixed bag, I guess we'll say, when it comes to him. Marcus Sherrills fumbled a kickoff, which was quite punt, which was quite frustrating. I kind of call him hit and miss Sherrills, where the last couple years I called him fair catch Sherrills, where basically he'd fair catch everything, except for the couple that he actually thought that he didn't need to fair catch. He could try to return. He would get a huge return out of it. I'm calling him hit and miss Sherrills because sometimes he's just not that good, but other times he's awesome when it comes to the return. Definitely not the kind of guy you want out there playing major minutes, major snaps at the cornerback position. I mean, do you even want him out there on the dime? I guess you might have to at times, but that's about it. Certainly not a nickelback, in my humble, very humble opinion. Sean Prater is a guy that I think he's going to continue to get more playing time out there, more snaps. Robert Blanton is going to play Sundays as well, without a doubt, in my humble opinion. Mistral Raymond barely noticed him out there, but then sometimes that's a good thing too. Sometimes it is. So overall, just a very solid defensive game. Offense not as sharp as the score would indicate, but hey, Bridgewater completed what he needed to, and it was a thing of beauty. He didn't get tested as much as I would have liked. That's the bummer part. I'm sure we'll see a significant amount of playing time for Mr. Bridgewater in the next game, and I'm sure we'll see some significant playing time out of old Christian Ponder in the next game as well. Aren't you looking forward to it? Don't you love watching Christian Ponder out there? Aren't you excited? Well, it's the fourth game of the preseason. There's fun to watch in that one, watching guys compete for the team. Maybe last-ditch efforts at starting jobs as well, or maybe backup versus like reserve per se. It's better to be a backup than a reserve, you know, like be like the third string guy who's maybe deactivated, guys that'll maybe just barely hang on by getting into the practice squad. We'll see where things head there. I believe I mentioned this on the last show, and if I didn't, I apologize, but I'll just say it now. Jerome Simpson suspended for the first three games, so for the second time in 3 years, Jerome Simpson is going to miss a few games to start the season. Oh goody. Wouldn't be surprised if this is his last year with the Minnesota Vikings, if he survives this preseason, because there are other Viking receivers that look good, like Adam Thielen and such, and the likes. Also, Matt Asiata, notable, looked pretty good in this game as well. I mean, he had a 31-yard catch and scamper on a screen pass in this game. Kyle Rudolph looked good as well. Cordell Patterson overall the best, but Asiata, very strong game. Very strong game. Jerick McKinnon, I'm still a huge fan of. Can't wait to see him continue to develop. And even Dominique Williams, I almost called him Dominique Wilkins, but Dominique Williams looks good as well. Joe Banyard, man, I really like him, but I think he's going to have a hard time. There's just too many other pieces right now. Asiata, Jerick McKinnon, I think it's going to be those three. Unfortunately, Matt Asiata hanging on despite having some pretty weak efforts in previous weeks. Looked good this one, so rock and roll. Of course, no Adrian Peterson. You know he's not going to play in the fourth game. So, hello, St. Louis Rams when it comes to Adrian Peterson. Speaking of the St. Louis Rams, and you know, Adrian Peterson had an ACL. Sam Bradford had an ACL last year, and he had his knee hyperextended the other day. And after the MRI, well, a lot of people figured, oh, it's not an ACL. He'll be okay. It's just hyperextended. You know, I'm sure he'll be available for week one. He'll be all right. No, it's another ACL, and it sucks. I feel for him. I do. And yes, he's making a lot of money. We'll hear from Justin Day on that in a few minutes here. But at the same time, I do feel for him a bit. It's kind of sad. Maybe more so I feel for Rams fans as well. But the way some people out there might be like, hey, well, Trent Green had an ACL, and in came Kurt Warner. Now it's John Hill's turn. Sean Hill, Kurt Warner, Sean Hill. I don't know about that. We'll be right back for the fan interaction. Hey, it's hot, it's humid, it's summertime. Nothing is more refreshing this time of year than Halcyon Wheat Ale, brewed by Tallgrass from Manhattan, Kansas. Their 8-bit pale ale is my personal favorite and the official beer of this podcast. There is nothing cooler than seeing Pac-Man licking his chops on this amazing can, and even better beer. Check out the many other wonderful beers Tallgrass offers on their website at www.tallgrassbeer.com. Check out their beer locator to see what's available in your area. You can follow Tallgrass on Twitter at TallgrassMN and find them on Facebook. Simply search Tallgrass Minnesota. Bringing people together over a beer since 2007.
Shop on Amazon? Did you know that you can support this podcast just by doing your normal shopping on Amazon? It's really easy to do. Just go to thesportsstuff.com and click on one of the many Amazon pictures. Do your normal shopping, and Amazon sees that we referred you and they give us a percentage. We'd like to thank you in advance for supporting thesportsstuff.com, and please use our Amazon link. Now enjoy the rest of the show.
Too busy to sit in front of a computer? Simply download Purple Mafia on iTunes for Apple devices. For Android, download the Double Twist app. And for Windows and BlackBerry phones, simply find us in the store. And now, back to Paladino Joey. Contact us and support Purple Mafia by liking us on Facebook and following us on Twitter. Don't forget to call into our phone lines at 209-736-7877. That's 209-736-7877.
Yes, call for Joey and Purple Mafia. Did my eyes deceive me last night, or did I see guys in purple uniforms actually catch passes thrown by the other team and sack players? Or did that actually happen? Because I'm not used to seeing that. This defense, I tell you, may not be Purple People Eaters quality yet, but with enough time in Zimmer's system, it could be someday soon. We're in for an exciting season. Let's go Vikings. Keep up the good work, Joey, and man, it would suck to be a Rams fan right now with Sam Bradford tearing his ACL again. Ponder the Rams? We can only hope, huh? Catch you later. Bye.
And I thank you very much for that call, Brent. See guys out there? Now do you see why I like to keep the calls to a minute? Look how sharp that was. That was awesome. See how it's much better when the calls are down to a minute. It's nothing against anybody. I mean, I love the calls. And I love all the takes you made in the past, everybody out there that have called in. But just saying how it's important that you're more sharp like that and not so relaxed, kind of like, eh, you know, the Vikings, yeah, you know. Christian Ponder, he just sucks. And, you know, that Matt Cassel, he's all right. And, see, it's better when you're sharp, when you're more sharp. That's kind of what radio's about. I'm guilty of it at times, too. We all need, I'm ever improving. I could be a 50-year veteran, and I'd still want to improve. I'm definitely not a 15-year veteran. This is going to be my 7th season already? Holy smokes. Yeah? 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Yeah, this is my 7th season of Purple Mafia already. Holy smokes. That time is just going too quick. All right, so let's be sharp instead of rambling on and on about random stuff. Purple players getting interceptions and sacks. Yes. Very cool. Very cool observation. It's real. Yeah, it is real. Just like the 7 million bats I saw flying around tonight in this humid, cruddy weather with, I guess, must be multi-million mosquitoes out there for those bats to be eating. That or Count Dracula's coming. Yeah, I know. Fall's got to be here pretty soon, but We'll see. It was very cool. It was very nice to see. This defense is unbelievably better. And it is kind of crazy when you think about how the previous coach, yeah, he also was a defensive coordinator. Good job, Bill. Rick Spielman. I almost called him Bill Spielman. What in the hell? Good job, Rick Spielman, in hiring this guy. You know, not just jumping on the whole thing. Well, you know what? Since the last guy was a defensive coordinator, we might as well go offense. You know, the defense was worse than the offense last year. It really was. And the offense is showing that it's fairly decent. Oh, and by the way, Mike Zimmer hired Norv Turner to coach the offensive side of the ball. Yeah, funny how that works. Two extremes working together, that's a pretty good thing, actually. It's pretty nice. It's actually quite nice. This defense looks really, really sharp, really on the ball, literally. Rushing the quarterback, getting interceptions. Players are where they need to be to make plays, which they were not last season, and they were not in 2011. 2012 was kind of a phenomenon. And, well, I guess the Vikings defense was fairly decent in 2012. It was decent. Whatever the hell changed in 2013, I have no idea. But we also had the MVP of football that year running the ball that kind of helped maybe a 7-9, 8-8 team become a 10-6 team. It might have helped a little bit. In fact, I kind of think it did, actually. Kind of think so. Especially late that Green Bay Packer game. That was one of the best games in a long time, actually, that us Viking fans have enjoyed. Probably the best since any game in 09. So, yeah. As for Sam Bradford, absolutely, man. I feel for him. Really sucks. And, yes, he's got a nice paycheck. But in the NFL, once in a while, people get cut. I'm sure the Rams won't cut him. And even though I bet in a way they probably wish they could. Yeah, it would suck, though, to like go out there and then your ACL goes again just like that. Man, that's just some serious bad luck. So we'll see what happens with that one. Christian Ponder to St. Louis, you say? Yeah, that would be nice. That would be actually quite cool. But now it sounds like it's going to be Mark Sanchez. The St. Louis Rams are interested in Mark Sanchez of the Philadelphia Eagles. No, not making that up. But yeah, he's, I guess, another Ponder in a lot of ways. Mark Sanchez. Cute. Very cool. So, yeah, it's one underachieving, meh, kind of a high, meh, like draft pick after another. Man, Mark Sanchez, yeah, I mean, he was taken higher than Ponder, wasn't he? In fact, he was taken really high. Really, really high. Crazy. Yeah. Well, there you go. There it is. Mark Sanchez to St. Louis. No, unofficial, of course. So, yeah, fantastic call. Let's, keep them coming, whoever you are out there, you know, whoever wants to call. But yeah, keep them to a minute if you could. Please keep them to a minute. I really would appreciate that. That way you're sharper. You get your points out, and which is something I need to continue to improve on as well. Mark Carlson, this was in the post of, I know, it seems like every time I post out, the newest show is out, blah, 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 on iTunes. I usually get a lot of posts in here telling how they felt about the show. Well, two guys from Iowa were posting in this one. And Mark Carlson saying, I missed the game, but not the podcast. That being the second game of the preseason against the Arizona Cardinals, Dennis Green's former team. He says, the family was busy outdoors with the second annual Shish Kebab Fest here at the house. I should have had the foresight to put a TV outside. Yeah, look at you. Thanks to Paladino Joey, I am still up to date. But yesterday, Wednesday the 20th, I saw a CBS Sports News blurb that had Minnesota listed with four other teams at the bottom of the NFL. Wow. And it went on to say the Vikings will win only five games. Evidently, they have not noticed the coaching change and the updated roster. One more thing. While talking with my Viking friends locally, the stadium subject came up. Looking close at this year's schedule, we will be playing outdoors game after game. And as a team that played well indoors at home, I wonder how this will affect the team. For reference, week 9 to week 14, bye week included. Hope the team adjusts to the outdoor conditions and plays well. Skol, Mark from Iowa. Yeah, that's going to be very interesting to see how all that turns out. It really is, and very nice thoughts there, without a doubt. We'll try to keep moving. Dave Hickey saying, how about them Hawks, Mark? As in the Hawkeyes. Sean Prater, yeah. Alan Reisner, and always Greenway. The whole team looks pretty damn good, and AP hasn't even played. I'm thinking only 7 or 8 wins, though. They are 1 or 2 years away from really being a championship team. I like the way Bridgewater is playing, but I still think he should... I still think it should be Castle's job to lose. Right on the ball with just a, with pretty much, yeah, everything there. And yes, I'm really enjoying these the play of the Hawkeyes out there, the former Hawkeyes, including Chad Greenway. I'm actually pleased with Chad Greenway so far. He's certainly not perfect, and he got beat on one of the Arizona Cardinals touchdowns last week. But you know what? Like we always say, it's going to happen. It's going to happen. I mean, well, yeah, like you're going to shut out the other team. They're going to get 0 yards, 0 touchdowns, 0 this, 0 that. No, guys are going to get beat once in a while. Even the best get beat, including Mr. Big Mouth over there in Seattle, who shall remain nameless. On to Mark Carlson here. Says, the players are talented. I keep looking at the schedule. And each week there is more news, positive news, encouraging news that indicates a better season ahead. Our rookies show that they have star potential. I am most concerned about our D. So happy we took Anthony Barr, and who would disagree with you on the quarterback spot? No reason to stick the rookie on the field. Skull. Yeah, yep, absolutely. Both of you guys are star candidates with these strong comments. Very cool. Yeah, Matt Cassel should start. Yeah, he should. He's not, I don't know, obviously he's not Montana. He's not Brady. He might not even be Brad Johnson. Because Brad Johnson was kind of an occasional Pro Bowler out there. But then again, maybe he is Brad Johnson. Or Gus Frat or something. Like when Frat was better, not like necessarily. But then again, Frat was good both times he was on the Vikings, wasn't he? He just wasn't great or anything. He was good. Putting DeVaris Jackson as the starting quarterback for that Philadelphia game in 2008. I'm still bitter about that one, Mr. Childress. I'm going to take it easy now. I made a statement saying Bridgewater makes it look so easy. His release and the spirals he throws are the sign of a promising quarterback. That generated a decent amount of response here. Straight out of Melbourne, Australia, Cleveland Browns fan, LA Lakers fan, and very close friend of mine, and co-host, or host, because we like to bounce around back and forth with that one, of the Showtime and T-Wolves show. And, of course, he's also a co-host of the Courtside Podcast. Long introduction there. Vince Germano, yes, sir, simply says he's no Manziel. He likes to bring up Johnny Manziel every single time I say the word Bridgewater, doesn't he? Oh, Vinny. Hope you're listening, and thank you if you are. And, Johnny Manziel, huh? Okay, I'm not too mad at him for flipping off the... Washington Redskins. I have a lot of pinned up hatred for that franchise too. It's nothing to do with the name of the team necessarily. That's another topic. That's kind of, I guess I'll just let everybody whine and complain about it. Since so many people complain about it, I don't need to really talk about it too much. There's too many other things to talk about. Everybody else, you know, wants to go on and on about certain subjects. Like Michael Sam and this and that. To, for me, you know what? You guys want to, since you want to say we have to talk about it, not necessarily. Since everyone else is talking about it, why should I have to necessarily? You know what I'm saying? Why not just go in a different direction sometimes? Anyhow, Justin Mayer Henry saying about Bridgewater, of course. Now that I've gone all over the place already, he says yes, he does. He's going to be such a great player. So glad we've got him. Cassel didn't shine quite as bright tonight, but overall I'm still super excited for the season to get started. High hopes, and it looks like it's going to be a fun year to be a Vikings fan. Skol. Still keep thinking we don't even have AP in yet. That's going to make a hell of an impact this year. Multiple threats. Yeah? Strong. Very cool there, Justin. Very cool. Yeah, I mean... Yep, this does have the looks of a promising season. I'm going to keep the predictions on wins and losses, per se. for the season preview. I traditionally do that. Hopefully, I'll get Dylan. He seems like I'm able to reach him now. He changed his number. It's like, whoops. So I was like texting the wrong number and I was thinking, what happened to him? Is he okay? But yeah. Good, great shout out to the awesome Dylan Richardson, the creator and executive producer of thesportstuff.com. Patrick Grant saying, going to be a great season. Dave Hickey saying, I love the way the team is playing so far. Defense is going to wreak havoc on other teams, and our offense is stacked with playmakers all around. How about my two boys from Iowa, Sean Prater and the Bridgewater to Allen Reisner touchdown connection? Yeah, baby, Skull Vikings. Brent saying, I'll be calling in tomorrow sometime if you haven't already recorded. And yep, and we got that going. And he says, sweet, keep up the good work. Dave Hickey saying, God, I hope Teddy is the savior of our team. I think they need to bring him along slowly unless Cassel... Oh, whoops. There we go. Unless Cassel really struggles. Teddy, he does look good throwing touchdowns. I can't wait until Norv's new offense with AP running and catching the ball with a little opening. And he's loose, as Paul Allen says. He gets yelled on the TV from PA. It's going to be an exciting year for the whole team. Offense, so many weapons. Defense, the pass rush is going to be heavy, and that's going to create a lot of turnovers right back into our ass-kicking offense. That's what Childress used to call it. The defense is so much better, isn't it? I mean, that's probably the theme of this week's episode, is the defense is as wonderful and sharp as Teddy Bridgewater looks out there. And it's a cool connection. This week's theme is the defense. And yes, the special teams helped as well with those nice returns. Adam Thielen is going to make this team, by the way. And if Adam Thielen doesn't make this team, I'll be flat out shocked. And I don't care if he's from Minnesota, Hawaii, or Tokyo, Japan. I don't care where he's from. He's a receiver that deserves to make this Minnesota Viking roster. It has nothing to do with any type of, oh, Minnesota, Minnesota, Minnesota. Yeah, whatever. So, now I talk about Sam Bradford, and then we'll wrap up with other posts shortly. Brent Jacobson saying, I wonder if the Rams will run with Sean Hill, or they might be interested in Ponder. Yeah, like I was saying, looks like it might be Mark Sanchez. Sebastian Balls, yes, sir, you'll be hearing his voice once again on this show pretty soon, I got to think. You know, all three of these guys will probably be on this show at some point. Brent Jacobson, Sebastian, and Justin Day. Kind of funny when you think about that. Sebastian saying, oh, sorry about this. Sebastian saying, I really hope the Vikings are looking at it. It would be good for... Pardon me, this thing is acting up. It would be good for the team to get another pick late in the draft. We draft well, even with the late rounders. Yeah? Yeah, we do. Most of the time, yeah. I mean, look at Michael Motti. Holy moly. You know, and look at some of these other guys this year. Not bad at all. Justin Day saying, I can't feel too bad for a guy that he's got 50 mil. I mean, that's got 50 mil in his bank account. I mean, I'd love to have my knee blown out two or three times. Ouch. And have 50 million. That said, okay, I feel a little bad for him. And the Vikings will not trade him, being Ponder, till after week one. He knows too much about the offensive system. Insider trading, no chance. Yeah, and I don't think Ponder will be traded, even if we want it, and even if they want it. Multiple reasons, obviously. There's just nothing going on with Mr. Ponder. And, of course, I just don't think that... I don't think he is going to get traded. I kind of think he's going to be the third stringer this year. Regardless if we like it or not, I think he is going to be the third stringer. And I apologize. This thing is just... I don't know what it's doing. I'm actually using the iPad, too, but the actual recorder here is kind of... Yeah, that's just how it goes. Leave us a couple more posts here. Yes, sir. Okay, look at this guy. Sebastian putting up some funny picture about the... a big, heavy guy wearing a Packers, like, thong-looking thing. Alrighty, then. I'm pretty sure it's Photoshop, by the way, but who knows? Sebastian saying, with Bradford out, do you see us winning week one? Yeah. I kind of think we will, but I'm going to leave that alone for now. Yeah, I'm going to save that for the next episode. Couple of posts in here. Wow, look at this. Kind of busy. What the heck? There's a lot going on in here. You guys are posting a lot. Some of it's in-game stuff that I'm not going to really get into. Boy, lots of posting in here. Holy moly. Oh, yeah. Johnny Manziel's middle finger. Posted by Brent Jacobson. Sebastian showing the two quarterbacks saying, says it all. Yeah. It's a lot better situation, isn't it? Nice picture of Teddy Bridgewater from behind in this one, saying, imagine how much better Teddy will be after he gets to sit on the bench this year and watch quarterbacks be faced like Cutler, Stafford, Drew Brees, Aaron Rodgers, Matt Ryan of the Falcons, Tom Brady, and that's a lot of learning. Yeah, he gets to see a lot of quarterbacks out there, doesn't he? And yeah, Bridgewater's going to learn a lot in this system. It's going to be great, too. It's going to be great for him to learn in this system. It's, I mean, how can you not love it? And now the pictures of, tickets. Tickets for Adrian Peterson for tickets for Game 3 of the preseason, or regular season against the New England Patriots. He's saying, here they are, folks. As promised, here they are, physical proof of the tickets. I will take whoever is willing to pay for the ticket. Message me or comment if interested. Skull. By the way, I did get them for a steal, so it might be worth looking into with Adrian Peterson. Since Viking Sebastian continuing saying, Viking fans, everyone on the Facebook pages say we have zero passing game. Yeah, I think we have a passing. Yeah, he says, okay, good one. Cassel has torn it up. Teddy's playing well. I'm sick and tired of people saying we will be the joke of the NFL. Just saying. Yeah, I mean, I can't believe anybody would say that. It's crazy. Now there's some in-game stuff. I'm going to kind of pass on that for now. Brent Jacobson saying, I know it's just preseason, but boy, does Mike Zimmer's defense look legit. Sebastian saying, Skull, another win. Offense looked okay. Defense was amazing. And no, continue to post all you want on there. I mean, that's the whole point, is to have activity and have fun during the thing. I'm just probably not going to read in-game commentary necessarily on air unless it's like a huge play, obviously. Well, I mean, I'm sure there, yeah, the two picks, the captain and flash, touchdown Teddy. Yeah, those are great. I mean, don't stop posting that, Sebastian and others out there, without a doubt. But kind of the overall commentary, I'm going to kind of pass on that. Otherwise, it'll be like way too long. Sebastian saying, to analyze the game against the Chiefs, all factors. Obviously, we don't have all the factors. Obviously, there is no Peterson, but the Vikings did play pretty much every other starter. The only starter that I saw the Chiefs were not playing was their running back. So when you take into consideration Matt Cassel had a decent game, it makes you think about the quarterback competition. Cassel threw an interception that was just brutally ugly, and it was. Yeah, I agree with Sebastian there. Our defense did not give up a single touchdown until the fourth quarter. Yep. Chad Greenway was expected not to play halfway through the week with a recurring wrist injury. Yep. That he did not have surgery on. Although Sean Prater, Chad Greenway, and Captain Mutterlin all had interceptions for the Minnesota Vikings in Kansas City. If that is a showcase of how our defense will play going into the year, I am extremely excited. Granted, we did that, so basically we're going to leave that one. It was really exciting indeed. Yeah, he was saying how Teddy had only 40 yards, and yeah, part of that was because of, obviously, the field position didn't really have many to go on. Dave Hickey saying Sam Bradford's out for the season. Sounds like a good home. Sounds like a good home for one, Mr. Ponder. Then we can hand the Rams a beatdown in week one. I doubt Ponder would play that soon, but desperate nature of the Rams could be in a third-round pick for Mr. Ponder. Ooh, I don't think they're going to give us that much. unfortunately, it looks like they're looking at Sanchez, which sucks. Sebastian saying, trade Ponder, get a late pick, sign Tebow. Sebastian again saying, Ponder has brought the Vikings to the playoffs more recently than Cutler. Yeah, isn't that crazy? Yeah. So that will wrap up the Facebook page. Yeah, isn't that crazy though? Ponder has brought the Vikings to the postseason. Ponder has brought the Vikings to the playoffs more recently than Jay Cutler, which is crazy. Though Cutler did take the Bears to the NFC title game. That is important, but at the same time, Kind of funny when you think about it. Kind of crazy, actually. Quite crazy. See, not too much going on in the Twitter at Purple Mafia Show, of course. Al Lambert's saying, cool name, man. And hopefully he did check it out. He said, iTunes, you hit the big time. Cool. Hopefully you're listening, Al. He said, at GDelly77. So give him a follow if you like. Hopefully he doesn't mind me saying that. And only one other comment. Antonio Fett at Antonio Fett. Like, you know, like Boba Fett at the end. F-E-T-T after Antonio. This being Anthony Carlson, the son of Mark Carlson, off in the Army, saying, I'm pretty impressed with the way the Vikings have been playing this preseason, hoping for a strong start to the season. And I think it will be. I feel calm and confident watching this team right now. Obviously in the preseason, I sit down much more analytical, not jumping up and down like, oh my God, this and that. You just kind of sit down, you shake your head at this and that, and you smile at this and that. That's kind of what the preseason is. And it's mostly analyzing this players, how well they're fitting in and the schemes and all that good stuff. And right now, I really have a good vibe going into the regular season. We're not there yet, though. Got one more game to play. We'll probably see a Cassel play maybe a couple seconds, if at all. Maybe one series or two, and then you'll see Teddy Bridgewater play maybe the first half, and Ponder play the second half. Oh, goody. But we're going to see a lot of Teddy Bridgewater in that last game, I think, and I can't wait for that. We're going to see a lot of other guys like Audie Cole continue to get tons of playing time. I mean, he's all over the place out there. You're going to see more Gerald Hodges. You're going to see Michael Motti. You're going to see guys like that. I'm a fan of both. I'm a fan of both Hodges and Motti, by the way. Penn State linebackers. Big fan. Big fan. I don't think there's any doubt those guys make the team. Obviously, Hodges pretty much has to. And Motti, I mean, no kidding. He's got a chance to be a solid player in this league as well for a while, I think. He's a guy with multiple ACLs in his career. So, you know, people do come back from that. Some come back better than others, and Motti looks like he's been doing that. He's no stud like maybe he could have been if not for the injuries, but he's gonna carve out a nice career, I think. That's the good news. Chad Greenway in ACL way back at the beginning of his career. So guys come back. They do. Without a doubt. Want to thank all of you so very much for your comments and all of the above. You've all been fantastic. I should pass out the stars, though, because I forgot to last week. Malcolm would get the gold star last week, though. I'm going to remember that. Malcolm, gold star for last week. I'm going to leave that as is. Yep, he gets the gold star for last week. This week, it's got to be Dave Hickey. He was all over the place. You know, fantastic. Take after take after take. Gets the gold star. Brent Jacobson gets the silver. And Sebastian and Mark Carlson get the bronze. Both all over the place. Fantastic. Brent Jacobson with a great call-in. You know, obviously he's going to get one of the three stars. Hickey's going to get the gold. Brent, silver, and then Mark Carlson and Sebastian with the... ultimately, I'm actually going to give the bronze star to Justin Mayer Henry, actually, because his take was really good, too. It's like I could give everybody I could give everybody a star. It's just kind of tough. It's tough. And lots of these guys have had trillions of stars already. Justin Mayer Henry is going to get the bronze for this one. So I'm going to leave that as is. Thank you all so much for listening to this show. But first, I got to do the gold star sound. There it is, Dave Hickey again, yet another gold star. Wow, all over the place in this one. So, thanks again, everybody. We'll be back for the fourth game of the preseason. And go Teddy Bridgewater, and absolutely go defense.